I've still got something I have to do. I want to check on Rebecca Kean.
Well, there's no need to. I just have.
How is she?
She's making a rapid recovery. Sister was going to stay the night with her, but it's not even necessary now.
Good.
She nearly jumped out of her skin when I went into the room. I think she was expecting Joan.
Yes, I'm worried about that.
Let go!
Watch it, Adams. You haven't got your friends to look after you now. What the hell do you think you're doing?
Trying to get away from you, Miss Ferguson. And you let me go. Do it or I'll scream rape.
Oh, get on the queue, Adams. That's been tried before and I'm still here.
Well, I don't try, Ferguson. I do.
Yes, I do care for Pixie. I know that. You know that. Everybody knows that except Pixie. And would you like to know why I never told her? I care about her. I'm not a sex maniac. I'm a lesbian. There is a difference,
come
you know
on, Jude,
that?
I'm not
anyway,
saying...
Who are you to come in here and tell me how to run my life? What makes you such an expert?
Come on, Jude.
You've murdered your husband. Your daughter's a drug addict.
Jude.
That makes you...
Shut up!
Yeah, I'll shut up. You're top dog. I'll do anything you say.
That's it, isn't it? I'm top dog and you're not.
You wouldn't have a clue, Myra. Get out!
Tell me our Miss Krantz is gone.
She's now off to an opening the other side of town.
God, how does she do it?
I feel like I've done 20 laps just listening to her, and she's still firing on all six.
Well, how about a coffee to recharge the batteries?
You're on. Hey, I'm not stopping you from working, am I?
Well, yes, you are. But thanks. Doing the rosters takes second place any time.
My feelings exactly. Every time I sit down to do paperwork, I break out in spots.
And you work for the government. You are in trouble.
No, I just avoid the paperwork.
You take milk?
Please. Oh, thanks. I'd like to ask you a favor.
Ask away.
I thought I could pay you back for all the help you've been by shouting into a plate of spaghetti at my favorite wine bar. I can pick your brains about some of the women here without stopping you working, and we can...
Sounds very nice. Excuse me. Staff room, Meg Morris.
Meg, I'm sorry to bother you.
What's the matter?
The police have suggested I stay somewhere else tonight, and I was wondering if you'd mind very much if I came to your place.
No, no, of course not. What's happened?
Oh, I'll tell you later. It's all right, then. I'm not putting you out.
No, no, no. It's fine. Look, I won't be home for another hour or so, but there's a key on top of the meter box. Now, let's let yourself in, and I'll be there soon.
Thanks, Meg.
Okay.
Don't worry. They serve spaghetti every night of the week.
Hmm? Look, oh, I'm sorry.
We'll leave it till tomorrow, and hey, look, I better get out of your hair so you can finish up.
Right. Thanks.
She'll be right.
I can't do it. It's just not fair. What's happened to freedom of speech? That's what I'd like to know. Rotten bastards. Oh, hell.
I take it you've heard about the suspension.
You bet I heard. Ferguson just couldn't wait to tell me.
It's not worth getting tied up in knots about. I can't say I didn't expect it.
Oh, but that's the point, Den. You stood up for something you believed in, and some power-hungry pig who doesn't even know the situation pushed the department into getting you suspended.
Well, let's not forget it was me who broke the rules.
Bugger the rules. You broke the picket line for good reasons. You've got to appeal.
No, have you were right. You can't have your members just going off and doing what they want in the middle of a strike. I was lucky to get away with a suspension.
Yeah, yeah. But I still think it stinks. You're a good officer. More to the point, they need you there. What a rotten, bloody week. First Doris and now this.
Oh, honey, that's great news. So is Cleary going to organise for your sister and father to pay you a visit then?
Yeah.
Well, why the long face?
Oh, your father, is that it? You said it. I left home because of him before. Who needs it again?
suppose if I want to see Cheryl, I have to put up with him.
Yeah, but it might not be that bad. He's had a lot of time to think things through. He might be really happy to have both his daughters with him again. Anyway, you'll never know what it's like unless you try it, love. And think of it this way. When you get out of here, you've got a family to go to, huh?
Never thought of it like that.
Yes.
Okay, come on, everybody. Don't sit down there, Ange. Everybody up and exercising. Let's go. Come on.
Like hell you do. You've done enough of that rubbish. You've got to dance.
Oh, we'll get enough of that tomorrow. What we need to do is get fit. Come on.
Now, what's the good of being fit if you're going to fall over your partner and break your leg? Now, I'm coach of this team. You do what I say. Isn't that right, Jude?
No, don't ask me. Don't involve me in anything. All I want to do is curl up in a corner somewhere after the workout you put me through this afternoon.
See, that's just what I'm talking about. We've all got to be fit. Hell, it starts tomorrow.
Where's Myra and Alice? I'm buggered if I'm going to bust a gut when only half the people are here.
Well, those two are all right. You two can't waltz to save yourselves.
Up yours, we do all right. Yeah, since when did you become the expert?
Listen, will you guys just can it for a minute? Now, there's no way that I'm going to do any exercise or any dancing at all on a full stomach. Let's just wait till Myra and Alice get here, okay?
Good one, Jude.
Come on, Angel, let's knock a few balls around. Watch which cue you use, though. The skinny one with glasses is called Dot.
I think you heard a feelings rabbit.
Talk about touchy. I give up.
Thought you'd go. Now, I decided to look in on Kean first. Seems to have recovered pretty well.
Actually, Mrs. Reynolds wants to speak to you about that. She wants you to stay away from Kean while she's in the hospital.
I see. Can't be trusted, is that it?
No, it's not.
Look, it doesn't seem to be enough, does it, that I have the full backing of the union and the blessing of the department. You and Reynolds have to continue your vendetta.
Did it ever occur to you that we might actually be trying to protect you from further accusations?
No, it didn't. Because no one in this place would lift a finger to help me, Morris. So you can save your energy. But I'll leave when I'm good and ready. It may be sooner than you expect. I don't care if you were the general manager before you were married, Kean. We've got enough trouble around here without letting you lot loose among the paperwork.
But
if you want to work, you can scrub the toilet block or go to your cell.
Excuse me, Miss Ferguson, but Mrs. Reynolds might welcome the help. Don't forget we're going to be short-staffed after tomorrow. I'll mention your offer, Kean.
All right, you lot, move out. You've got 3 minutes to get to your work areas. Come on, don't take all day.
All right, Adams, just a moment. What's happened here to your shirt?
Look, can I have a word with you, Mrs. Morris?
You were told to move out, Adams.
She'll be along in a moment. Miss Ferguson?
Oh, be careful!
You could have broke something.
What's the hold-up here?
I just tripped over, that's all. God. Right.
I'll tell you
when it's
all right.
Now, get up pieces out of me in the morning.
Well, you're Reb's mother, aren't you? That's
that shouldn't make any difference. I know what everyone's been saying, but I know she didn't bash Rebecca. No, it was someone called Winter. Mari or Mary or something like that.
It is none of your business, Warren.
What did you say, Warren?
I said I think I hurt my knee today.
What a shame, you might miss the marathon.
No, it's not that bad.
It will be if you don't get a move on.
Oh, God, look at this shirt. I should have gone home and got a clean one.
It is a notice. Hey, look, have you seen this? We've actually made the papers without starting a riot.
Is that from yesterday? Show me. Oh, God, look at the women, will you? It's a wonder Cliff Young wasn't crushed to death. Oh, that's our Marl. Hey, where's this? I'm going to stick it on the notice.
You're over by the phone, I think. Well, I better get going. I don't want to get the sack as well, do I?
Dan, how can you joke about it?
What do you want me to do? Go around with a long face, eh? See you later, funny face.
Oh, I just wanted the roster copies, actually.
Oh, Joyce, thank heavens you came when you did. You see this woman? I think she was trying to make advances.
Dennis. Oh, Dennis, we're really awfully sorry about what's happened.
Oh, thanks, Joyce, but that's the way it goes. And none of us are going to burst out in boils, right? Oh, it was very kind of you.
Oh, it's just awful what's happened to Dennis. He's such a good officer.
Yeah. Ferguson batters a prisoner and keeps a job. Dennis comes in to help the women and gets punished for it. I think it stinks.
Thank you. Oh, before you go...
Yes?
I believe you're thinking of leaving us. Do you have a firm date in mind?
No, Governor, I don't. But if and when I do, I'll advise the department. In the meantime, I would appreciate it if you would tell Mrs. Morris not to spread gossip, especially about me.
Oh, she wasn't spreading gossip. It's all right, Meg, come in. And must it go all right?
Yes, fine. Oh, and I had a very interesting talk with Adams.
Yes, I meant to speak to you about that one, Governor.
Fun?
Well, you see, I happen to know that that sweet act of hers is all a cover. She's already causing trouble amongst the women.
Funny, I hadn't noticed it.
Perhaps you've been too busy with staff room gossip, Mrs. Morris, to give the women your usual attention.
I beg your pardon.
Precisely what I said.
Miss Ferguson, if you have any personal grievances, you will talk to me about them in private. I will not have my staff brawling in this office. Now, about Adams, you had something to tell me.
Yes, she gave me this to give to you.
It's a handkerchief. Rather a beautiful one, I don't understand.
It's a present for you. She embroidered it herself.
Lovely. Don't you think so, Miss Ferguson?
Excuse me, Governor.
God, she's getting worse, if that's possible.
She is. Well, I suppose we should have expected it after what she's been through.
How are you feeling?
Oh, I'd feel all right if I could forget about these damn letters.
Police come up with anything?
No. They can't even work out how the letter got into my flat. No one saw anything. No locks were broken. Oh, Meg, I'm worried. Worried sick.
Oh, no.
Oh, what's wrong, love?
I've broken the needle and I'm only halfway through this thing.
No worries. There's some more needles in that little drawer on the left there. You know how to replace it?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I used to do it for my nanny. Her eyes were bad.
Yeah.
Positive and negative?
Yeah, sort of. Like a magnet. But the only thing that can hurt me here is if I get near the clothes dryers or hair dryers.
Like to swap jobs, love.
Hey, you still with us?
Huh? It's all right, love. I just said, would you like to swap jobs? My arms are aching from all these heavy sheets.
Oh, yeah, all right. Hang on, I'll just finish this.
She's a lovely kid. Not like some of the other young buggers in here.
Found out which screw is leading.
Look what you've done, you silly bugger.
Jeez, it would have to happen when the bloody thing was pulled.
Okay, so tell me, who's leaving?
Mr. Cruikshank, they're letting him go because he broke the strike.
They can't do that. He's a good screw.
You dirty old woman.
Oh, your mind's like a sewer. That's your
come
problem.
Come on, you two now.
It was
cut
a compliment.
Cut it out. When's he leaving?
Tomorrow sometime.
Oh, bloody Ferguson, eh? She's done it again.
Yeah. Hi, how was Phil, baby? Did you behave yourself?
Come on, ladies. Look busy. What is this terrible mess?
Oh, I had a bit of an accident this morning.
Well, pick it up. We'll never get finished in time for the marathon.
Oh, yes, we will. I've been jogging everywhere for training.
Come on, Adams. Your turn now.
Oh, it's my turn to see Mr. Cleary.
Yes, come on.
Oh, Mrs. Barry.
Yeah.
Is there any chance that Myra Winter will be sent back here?
No. She's gone to Blackmore. I bet you're all very pleased to hear it, huh?
Come on, dear.
Yeah, we're not the only ones that are pleased. I'll bet.
There you go. Compliments of Mr. Cleary.
Thanks.
Yeah. Okay. You changed your mind about seeing your mum?
Gotta be joking. It's that bitch's fault I'm back in here.
Now, come on. She thought you were dying. Any mother would have done the same.
Listen, she's only ever thought of one person in her life, and that sure as hell wasn't me. Now, ring off, will you?
Okay.
You're in suspension for trying to help the women. It's tough luck. For all of us. Screws go, you're not too bad.
Well, thank you, Rip. That's very kind of you.
Oh, don't thank me. If I hadn't dobbed Ferguson in, the strike wouldn't have happened.
No, you had to report it. Just the same as I had to do what I did.
Man's got to do, eh?
Look, now that I'm going, would you take a bit of advice from a screw that's not all that bad? You know, you're not going to get anywhere always rebelling against everybody. Makes for a bloody rotten life, if you ask me. And I'm talking about your mother, too.
Yeah, well, I've got a better idea, Cruikshank. You take care of your problems, and I'll look after mine. Especially me mother.
And so, I only have my Nana left. Well, you'd love her. She's the sweetest grandma anyone could wish for. But I guess that's one of the reasons why I got tricked into doing such terrible things. She always used to say, treat people nicely and they'll do the same for you.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I found out that isn't always true.
You're a very brave girl, Angel. I don't know of many people who could go through what you've experienced and not bear the world a grudge.
Well, I guess I don't look at it that way. But she said that God has his reasons and I can't very well get mad with him, can I?
No, I guess not. Well, obviously, the best thing I could do for you would be to call your grandmother and see if you can't go to live with her when you get out.
But you can't. You...
What's the problem?
Well, it's just that her health hasn't been too good lately, and if she finds out that I'm in prison, well, it could kill her.
Sorry, Mr. Cleary. I have to take Adams back now.
Yes, all right. Look, I'll see you again soon, Angela, and hey, don't worry. We'll work something out.
Thank you, Mr. Cleary.
You must realize it wouldn't be a full-time job, and of course you'd make more money in the laundry.
Oh, the money doesn't matter, Mrs. Reynolds. I'm just grateful to be doing some kind of work I'm familiar with.
Good. Let's settle then.
There is just one more thing.
Yes?
I know what you said, but, could I possibly see Rebecca? She was so ill, and I just want to make...
I'm sorry. I can understand how you feel. But she hasn't changed her mind. She still won't see you.
I'm sorry. I just wanted to explain to her why I did it. I didn't mean to hurt her. God knows I didn't.
Of course, I suppose I could arrange an accidental meeting. Make Morris, please.
What's this? Get out. Oh, it's us from yesterday. Why didn't you show us before?
But I had it. Not bad, eh? Mum takes a good photo. Mm.
Where'd you call this off?
Phil gave it to me.
Phil, baby, eh? Oh, that's why she wanted to give it to herself.
Nice, isn't he, Bobby?
He's all right.
I reckon you two will be fighting over him soon. Don't blame me, though. He's a spunk.
Not interesting.
Really?
Well, why would I be? I mean, we're crims. No one from the outside would want to mix with us.
Yeah, it's not fair, though, is it?
I bet I could get him if I wanted to. I
mean, you're wasting your time. He's probably got some unicut, you know, big brain, small boobs, eat sunflower seeds.
Oh, I'll strike out then.
Still reckon I could get him.
Aren't you two eating?
Yep.
Oh,
yuck. Yeah.
That's a lot.
I told you I didn't want her anywhere near me.
Quiet, she's just bringing your tray.
Can I have a word with you, Eddie?
Okay. Now go somewhere.
Just listen to me for 1 minute, and then I'll leave you alone. I said, get out! That's why I had to do it, don't you see? I thought you were going to die. You just lost your father, Rebecca. I couldn't bear to lose you, too.
You lost me a long time ago.
G'day, Becky.
Oh, Marlene, I've told you before. Don't call me that in here.
Oh, yeah, sorry. Did you see the photo of us with Cliff?
Not bad, eh?
You reckon he'll come along to the marathon and cheer us on?
No, I doubt it.
You can't eat that stuff either. It's been really off since Ray left.
Yeah, he wasn't bad. Hey, you better get going.
Yeah. Everyone's really upset about Mr. C leaving. We reckon it's really off doing it to a nice guy like that. I suppose you'll miss him most of all, eh? We reckon you and him have got a thing going.
Mine?
Oh.
Yeah, yeah. You'll miss him.
Well, cheer up. I mean, you can always see him after work, can't you? No need for you to be down in the dumps.
Yeah, I know.
And we need you to egg us on at the marathon, eh? You're not going to let me down now, are you?
It's a cosy little scene.
She was just leaving, Miss Ferguson.
Yes, I was just getting some tips about the marathon, the Sabo.
Get a move on, Warren, or the team will be one short.
Oh, yeah. Cynthia, somebody called. She said she's done what you wanted and it'll be finalised tomorrow, whatever that means.
Good. Hope you're adaptable, Rogers, because there's going to be some big changes coming up around here.
So I think any sort of class would help build morale. Of course, I'd rather teach them something useful, but that's up to you.
Yes, well, of course, I'll speak to the department about it. Sorry, Philip. I've got some urgent business to attend to.
Yes, all right. Well, I'll see you both tomorrow, and let's just hope that Bobby's father doesn't have a change of heart, eh?
Yes, well, from what you've told me, I think everything should be okay.
Nice to have someone genuinely interested in the women again.
Yes, it is. Now,
What did you want to see me about?
Damn!
Here, let me do it. It's all right. Why don't you take the rest of the day off?
I can
look after things here.
I'd rather keep busy.
Well, there's no worry about that. Barbara Crone's just rang. She'll be here in 20 minutes.
No, I don't think I could. Come on, Anne, pull yourself together.
Come on, don't worry. Police said this is the one place you can feel safe in.
Not anymore.
What?
I just had a phone call. They didn't say anything, but I know it was the person who's been sending those letters. Don't ask me how I know, I just know.
Did you call the police?
Yes, not that I could tell them much. Pat Slattery took the call. She couldn't even tell whether it was male or female. And whoever it was decided that if they didn't say anything, they'd frighten me more. They succeeded.
What did the police suggest?
They wanted to cancel the marathon for a start.
Why?
They're worried about all the unofficial people wandering in and out. They feel that he or she could slip through security. Of course, the department wouldn't be in it. I feel that all this publicity they've drummed up could make up for all the other problems we've been having.
God, that's typical, isn't it? Oh, too bad if you're in danger because of it.
Yes, well, what worries me is that if this person tries something, the women could be in danger as well. God, Meg, I just don't know what to do.
Driver.
Everything all right, ladies?
Fine.
Good. No, don't put that there. Move that over there in the corner. And any of those spare chairs, any others you can find, stack them in the corner over there. And we'll need those chairs straightened out over there for the officials.
And I want that one there. That one's there.
Oh, very nice. Very nice.
Dad did a good job, didn't he?
Excellent, Marlene. Are they all up now?
Yeah, I think so. Just had to put the hands on the clock.
If enthusiasm counts, there was for a week.
Mrs. Reynolds, Mrs. Irene said the tea's ready.
Oh, good. Well, you better get them out, Meg, if you want to start on time.
Mrs. Reynolds, can I talk to you about something, please?
Can it wait till morning, Heather?
Well, it's about Dennis leaving.
I'm sorry, I know what you're going to say, but there's nothing I can do.
Okay.
All right, everybody, off to the dining room.
Yay! Yeah.
Move
on!
I hope it's not too.
Whistle, Mrs. Morris.
What do you need a whistle for?
Every coach has a whistle. Can you get me a whistle, Mrs. Morris?
It's looking good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's wonderful.
Salad. How's that going to keep us till breakfast?
Yeah, well, this is not going to weigh us down.
Hey, that's a thought. Maybe we should just give it a miss altogether, eh?
Yeah.
You're the thank you, lucky stars, you haven't got an ulcer.
How'd you like to be poached fish all the time?
Are you going to eat that? Well, give us your meat then.
I'll have it all.
What's up? Mrs. O forget the caviar?
Bloody hell, she did. That's terrible. Fancy treating a lady like that.
Yeah, it must be bloody hard for you. You're even too good for us, aren't you?
Where are you going? Did you say you could go?
Yeah.
Did you say she could go, Alice?
No.
You let her go. Think you better come and eat with me, Deirdre.
Watch her, Deirdre. She's into forks.
Hey, Jude, over here.
Thank you.
She's what's got me to emerge. She acts weird sometimes.
Yeah.
I wouldn't let those two worry her.
Oh, it's not them.
Is it Reb, is it?
She really hates me, Judy. I mean, I know she didn't think much of me, but I didn't think she hated me that much.
She'll get over it. It takes time, that's all.
That's the trouble. Time is what I should have given her years ago. Anyway, it's not just that. It's this place. I think I'll go crazy if they give me a full slip.
Listen, Deirdre, why don't you... We'll try and mix in a bit more. Make a few friends. You know, try and fit in.
Fit in? Oh, my God, things are bad, but not that bad. I'll save your wages, Judy. I'll handle it by myself.
Well, you've got about 10 minutes to get set up. Now, keep the focus on Judy Bryant as much as possible. I will introduce you and... Oh, Miss Ferguson, has Mrs. Radcliffe got those speakers set up yet?
I wouldn't know. Why don't you go and check? You've obviously got more time to waste than I have.
Well, you're not leaving. Surely the marathon's about to start.
Lady, I gave up going to the circus when I reached puberty.
Wish we had that on tape, darling. It's the first time I've seen you stuck for words.
Good God. Attila, the Hun.
Come on, let's get cracking.
Okay.
Bobbie. You're making it worse than it usually is.
Oh, get stuffed. Your bloody hairstyle's nothing to write home about. Why don't you do something with it?
I want my friends to recognise me. That's why I'm going to send a cheerio on the telly.
Gee, there's no hope for you, rabbit.
There's your whistle. Dot, Nate, stop complaining.
Here, love. I want you to have these. I wore them to the first ball over 40 years ago. I only wore them on very special occasions, and I'd like you to wear them to the marathon.
Thanks, Doc. Hey, Ange, you coming? It's nearly five.
Oh, yeah, hang on a minute. I'll catch you up.
You better hurry.
And I think you better have a word with the coach, too. She's quite a character, Dot Farrah. Miss Farrah!
Gotcha.
Come along, Miss Krantz. We've only got 3 minutes now. Let's stop pussyfooting around and get this thing going. Hey, cut that out, you lot.
I'm being upstaged. You ready, Bob?
Yeah, okay, let's get this.
All right, everybody, the Wentworth Marathon is about to get underway. Could I have a hand for your team members, please? Judy Bryant and Angela Adams. Bobbie Mitchell and Myra Desmond. Marlene Warren and Alice Jenkins. Now then, for the basic rules, there must be no less than two couples on the floor at any given time.
Where's your gloves, Bobbie?
Oh,
I don't want to wreck them, Dot. They're antiques, they're real antiques.
Oh, hadn't thought of that.
Good. Refreshments can be taken on the floor, and regular breaks are rostered for each couple. Dancers must always stay in motion or forfeit the attempt. Now, we all wish you luck and hope you achieve your goal not only for yourselves, but for the children of the Deaf Institute. Yay! Ready, girls?
Yep.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! We've got what you're being bugged before you've got the lumps on the clock.
Oh, shut up, you stupid old tart.
We'll be cheeky and I'll disqualify you.
Excuse me, Miss Barron. I understand you trained these ladies for this event.
I certainly did, young fella. They weren't worth the tickets cuss when I started, but I soon ripped them into shape.
And so the Wentworth Marathon is underway. This is Bob Miller for Eyewitness News.
Keep going, Jude. It's your turn for a break next.
She's right. She just got the hots for Angela. Haven't you, Branch?
Come on, love. I think we better give Jude a break. She looks terrible.
Can't you wait another 10 minutes? My feet are killing me.
Come on, grizzle guts.
Judy, come on. I think you better take a break.
No. I'm
fine.
All
that blubber she carries.
Oh, shut up, Lou.
Come on, Jude. We're ready to go on.
You go on, Jude. You look like you're about to cark it.
Yeah. I think maybe I'd better stop for a while. I'm sorry, Angel.
Huh? Quick, because I had two on the floor.
Oh, hell.
Quick.
I don't know what's wrong with me. I hope I'm not going to ruin it for everyone, Mrs. Morris.
I think you better see the sister.
I think so.
Be okay, Judy?
We'll be fine.
Now you go and have a drink and a pee. It's only a short break.
Mara, what are we going to do if Jude's too sick to go back on?
Have to let Dot in, won't we?
Oh, good. Oh, watch me feet. Will you have me out next?
Sorry.
Feel like a bit of a walk in the night air?
Nervous about the hearing.
Yeah. Silly, isn't it?
No. Just keep telling yourself you'll be a mother this time tomorrow.
Oh. Never quite thought of it that way. Shane's mother. You know, I can give him everything he needs. A good, secure home.
feeling of being wanted, loved.
I know. I only hope you won't regret leaving the prison service.
Oh, no. I can assure you on that score. I've given 15 years of service, and what have I got? A lot of backbiting and petty politics. No, Father, after that hearing tomorrow, I'll have everything I need. I'll have you, Shane, we'll all be together.
Well, I really wish you'd take Sister's advice and give the rest of the marathon a miss, Judy.
Oh, no, I couldn't let everybody down like that. Anyway, I feel as fit as a fiddle now.
Well, make sure you see the doctor when he comes at the 12-hour mark.
Yeah, sure. Look, I think it was nothing. I mean, my pacemaker just, you know, did a little thing there.
I wonder what caused that.
Well, I don't know. I was fine before I started dancing.
Well, promise me, if it happens again, you'll drop straight out.
Oh, okay.
Well, I'll check you all out when I finish my run.
Sure, and don't you worry about me. I got about 70 hours worth of dancing in this old body.
What are you doing in here, Adams?
Oh, Mrs. Morris, you startled me.
You know you're not supposed to be in this area after 5.
Well, my bra strap broke. I was looking for a safety pin.
Well, I can give you one. Now, come on, your break is nearly over.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris, you're so good.
I feel fine. I don't know what was wrong with me. I think it was just something I ate, you know?
Oh, great. Well, keep up the good work. We're depending on you. And thank you for the lovely dinner, Mrs. Reynolds, but I'm afraid it's eat and run. I've got another promo due for the marathon, and I've only got 20 minutes to get there.
Well, thank you for all your help.
Oh, my goodness, I'll be here for the victory celebrations. You haven't seen the last of me yet. Keep up the good work, girls.
Thank you, Miss Grant. Hi, Angel, just in time. Well, let's get to it, huh?
Sure you're okay, Jude?
I'm fine. Okay, you two, off the floor. We're raring to go, huh?
About bloody time.
Oh, my aching feet.
Oh, we'll stick him up and I'll rub him for you. I can't get your blooming boots yet.
Oh, bloody awful music. Wish I'd change the tapes.
I reckon it's good stuff.
Oh, God, Shaper, you stop your bickering. Save your energy for the waltz, huh?
How the hell did I ever get talked into this? How long have we been doing it now?
Only 10 hours. Oh. We'll make it. We've got to make it.
Are you okay, Jude?
Yeah.
Good, huh? Only 62 and a half hours to go.
Worried there for a minute. I thought we had a burglar.
I'm sorry. Did I wake you?
Haven't you been to bed?
No, I couldn't sleep. Would you like me to get you some coffee or cocoa?
No, thanks, dear. You need some sleep. Everything's going to be all right tomorrow. Today. Worry isn't going to help anything.
Look, I'll be all right. Go to bed. I'll be all right.
In here. Hey, Granny. I think she snuffed it, girls. Not rigor mortis yet, anyway.
Why don't you leave her alone, Lou?
Oh, keep going, girls. Not too fast, Bobbie.
Oh, shut up, you stupid bitch. Can't you see I'm having a rest?
Oh, my arthritis has got me. Give us a hand, will you?
Don't look at us. Will you give her a hand, Lou?
Come on, you bag of bones.
Oh, jeez, my legs are still giving me hell. We'll be right after we have some brekkie.
Oh, you look terrible, Jude. Keep it up, love. We've got a long way to go yet.
Shut up, Dot. You'll make her feel bloody worse. Righto, ladies. All those not in the marathon, off to muster.
But who's going to egg them on?
You could come back in your lunch break. Now move it out, will you? Come on, hurry up.
Keep it up, Alice. You're doing better than that tub of lager carrying.
Kelly, move it.
Then when's brekkie? We're starving.
It is on its way.
Oh, beauty.
When does Judy get a break?
As soon as we have a shower.
Right, we'll go and have it straight away, will you?
Thank you. Ah, hello, Joan.
Honey, Joan!
Get back here.
Jeffrey. I don't want you going anywhere near her. She's bloody dangerous.
She's not. She's a nice lady.
Oh, yeah, real nice. Does a nice job of bashing prisoners, too. Now, shut up and do what you're told.
Charming character.
It's not true, Geoffrey. I didn't bash anyone.
Oh, yes, I know, Joan, but cross your fingers. Let's hope the opposition don't use it anyway.
Well, I hardly see how it's relevant here.
Yes, I know, but it doesn't help our case, especially as we're claiming Monroe's violent. All the publicity you've had recently places you under the same suspicion too, I'm afraid.
So you see, Your Worship, we're getting on real good now. One little talk about how everybody's got to have rules and he was a good kid. You know, did what I asked. He's a bright little fella. Now, we're getting on like a house on fire. And don't let nobody tell you anything. Hey,
thank you, Mr. Monroe. That will do.
Thank you, Your Worship. It's been an honour.
Just one moment, Mr. Monroe. We're not quite finished yet.
Sorry, sir.
One question, Mr. Monroe. If you're getting on like a house on fire, why did you offer to let Miss Ferguson have your son for $1,000 deposit?
Who told you that pack of lies? Huh? You don't want to believe a word that bitch says.
Mr. Monroe, I will not tolerate abusive language. Just answer Mr. Johnson's questions.
No. Of course I wouldn't do a thing like that. Couldn't, could I? I mean, he's my own kid.
Does that entitle you to maltreat and abuse him so badly he's forced onto the streets?
That's a load of bloody lies!
Your Worship, I have here a sworn statement from a doctor which will prove that the witness was charged on at least one occasion with a physical abuse
of
his son.
Maybe once or twice just to bring him to line. But at least I didn't bash him that bad until he died. And that's what your lily white Miss Ferguson done, isn't it? Bash some poor bloody prisoner half to death!
Your Worship,
that incident has not been proven. There's no relevance to this case at all.
Yes, Mr. Johnson. Mr. Monroe. You will contain your language. That's my last warning.
Oh, not more paperwork.
It's all right, it's all right. It's a doctor's report on Kean. She'll be rejoining the women in 24 hours.
Good.
Well, is it? I mean, what about Joan?
You can finish that filing later. Just take your break now, would you?
Rebecca's in danger from Miss Ferguson, isn't she?
Of course not. Now, would you please do as I ask you?
But Mrs.
Now, please.
Yes, Mrs. Reynolds.
Sorry. You weren't to know. And don't worry about Joan. We'll arrange something before King comes out of hospital.
Did you get any sleep at all last night?
Oh, a couple of hours. Stayed in isolation.
Oh, why? I mean, you know you're welcome at my place any time you like.
Yes, Meg, I know, and thanks. But until the marathon's over, I thought I'd have to stay around and keep an eye on things. Oh, and I've arranged for someone to collect some clothes for me. Would you tell me when they arrive?
Right. Look, if you're worried about the women, wouldn't it be more logical to stay right away from the prison?
I don't know what's logical anymore.
Oh, sorry. Didn't mean to upset you. Is there any news from the police?
You realise, of course, that it is most unusual for a single working woman to be granted permanent custody of a child.
Yes, I do.
The question is, can you adequately cope with a full-time job plus the time necessary to provide for the child's psychological as well as physical needs?
Well, Shane would be my first priority, of course. But I'm quite certain that I would have no trouble in handling a job and providing a good home.
Now, Miss Ferguson, would you mind telling us what, to your mind, is the best way of disciplining a child?
Well, I believe children should be given strong guidelines to follow. And if they break those rules, then they should be punished. But not by beating. I have never beaten a child in my life, and I could never contemplate doing so.
Since Mr. Monroe had a court order restraining you from seeing Shane, the boy has returned to visit you on several occasions. Is this so?
Yes. We became very close when he was staying with me, and he found it difficult to understand why he couldn't see me. Your Worship, I know how the court feels about children staying with their natural parents, but I couldn't love Shane more if I were his real mother.
Dot, the team members will be getting theirs in here.
Be buggered, that'll mean cold boiled fish. I'm going to the dining room.
Oh, I'm going too. Give us a hand up, Lou. I don't care what Mrs. O'Regan's serving, I need a change of scenery.
Okay, but hurry up. Adams?
I'd rather sleep.
All right.
You're not giving up. We're just going for a break.
Oh, good for you. They're doing well, aren't they? 19 and a half hours and we're still getting enormous coverage. Do you hear that, ladies? The public are behind you every step of the way.
You see, by law, you're not old enough yet to choose where you'd like to live. But that doesn't mean we don't consider your feelings on the matter. Do you understand that, Shane?
Yes, sir.
Good. Now, would you like to remain with your father?
No way. I just want to live with Auntie Joan.
You're certain of that?
Yeah. I don't want to go back with him. When he gets drunk, he starts bashing me.
You lying little bastard!
Mr. Munro! Mr. Munro! Mr. Abbott, speak to your client, please.
Hi. Mrs. Morris said you wanted to see me about something.
Yes, Heather, sit down.
Is there something wrong?
Yes, there is.
If it's about the way I've been sounding off at Miss Ferguson, I think...
It's got nothing to do with Miss Ferguson. Now, please.
Sorry.
I've been speaking to the governor of Blackmoor. She sent me a statement from Mari Winter, which claims that you were in league with her in a drug smuggling racket while she was here, and also that you helped her escape. Now, what do you have to say?
Now, custody cases are never easy for the parties involved. And I would like to point out that any decision made by the court has been arrived at with due consideration as to what is best for the child. Now, from the evidence brought before the court this day, it's my decision that Shane Munro should not be returned to his father. However, Miss Ferguson, although I commend you highly for the care you've given Shane, I must tell you that I feel it's in the boy's best interest that he be made a ward of the state until suitable foster parents can be found.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground.
the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.